I have a very fresh, okay, it's not really fresh, but it's very different sort of a video. I've never done one of these. Today I'm going to try out a bunch of makeup products that I recently picked up from a local makeup store from Jayanagar, Bangalore. Yeah, I don't have a full face of makeup products here, but I do have quite a lot, and this is the look that I created. You will see another version of this with a different lipstick right now. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this. If you want to see how these products work, what are the products I picked up, what are the brands I picked up, and just how I created this look, then please keep on watching. I've already used a facial oil before starting, but I'm just gonna double up my moisturization game with Pond's moisturizer. I've been using this from 3-4 months now. I've been loving this. This is, I think, my second one, and this lasts very, very long, and I absolutely love that. Okay, so let's get started. So for foundation, I'm going to be using my PAC HD Liquid Foundation. I know, before you guys jump onto me, let me clear this out. So for foundation, they only had this Olivia foundation, and that was like way too light. It looked almost white in shade, and of course there was no point picking it up. Like, I want to test out the products that I can really use on myself, so I didn't pick that up. So I'm just gonna quickly go ahead and put this on my face. I haven't used this foundation so long now. I've been using all the new foundations that have launched or I've tried. So I'm actually really excited to be trying this out after so long. Okay, so foundation is done. Now let's dive into the makeup products that I bought. So first off, I think I'm going to go ahead and do my eyebrows. I'm going to do the concealer part later on because I am excited for my eyebrows. So I have this product. This is the ADS Perfect Eyebrow Pencil. This is waterproof and long lasting, and it comes with this plastic spoolie, which, I mean, does nothing if you have very sparse hair. And this is in, if I can open it, and this is in black. So yeah, let's see how this goes. I'm gonna try to really concentrate this on the ends, and I'm just going to barely touch at the very start of my eyebrows. So let us see how this goes. Okay, this is truly black. Is barely doing anything. The spoolie is not really helping with like combing the hair, but it's actually just like spreading the product all over. So I'm not a fan of the spoolie, but like, it really gave definition right here. I mean, if you had to look from a distance, it looks like I have like a good eyebrow shape. Now is the tricky part. So I'm just gonna like, let's see how it goes over here, because if you know, if you go with a black eyebrow pencil over here, it can like break your look literally. So let's see how it goes. Okay, this is crazy pigmented. I'm going so light-handed. Oh no, there's like this blotch here. So I just looked at myself in the mirror very close, and from distance maybe you cannot tell, or maybe on camera you cannot tell, but in real life you can tell that I have like overlined my eyebrows with like a black eyebrow pencil. So no, I definitely do not have everything to do a full face of makeup. So what I've planned is I'm going to use all the products that I have from local makeup store first, and then I'm going to go ahead and finish my entire face with the rest of the products which I already use. So let's see what I can use next. So I think I have eye products now. So I have the eyelash, I have the glue, then I have a blue liquid eyeliner, a black liquid eyeliner. Both are from this brand called Insight. I also have a mascara. This is also from Insight. So we have a bunch of Insight eye products to try out. So let's start with that. Since I do not have eyeshadow, I'm planning on using the Huda Beauty liquid lipstick that I bought again from this local store as my eyeshadow base. So I'm just going to try, you know, what possibly can go wrong, hopefully. But yeah, let's just like put it here and give it like a brown smokiness to my eyes. I know I should be fixing my eyebrows, it just looks so bad right now. We'll do that after we try out the eyeliner. So this again says it's waterproof. Let's open this bad boy up and it is inside shiny eyeliner. Again, the packaging also says it's waterproof. So let's test this out. Oh wow, the tip is extremely fine, which is nice. Let's try this out. Quite pigmented actually. Not bad. It's quite liquidy and it's getting on my eyelashes. That is something that I hate about these sorts of liners. So I need to wipe this off now. I'm gonna try to create a wing now with this. The tip is just so fine that I'm not able to connect my wing that well and it's not looking that bold. So yeah, I mean, I wouldn't really be using this again, for sure. Before I go off camera and apply the liner on this side, I just want to quickly apply or try the mascara. Now this says that it's from inside, like the packaging says it's from inside. This is again their lash extension waterproof mascara, but the actual packaging here says VOV. So I'm not sure why there's like discrepancy, and that's the wand. I mean, I don't think it's going to work, but let's just give it a shot. I'm going to just do this. I do that with every mascara before applying. You don't want like a thick blob of product on your eyelashes. So it is working, as in it's lengthening my eyelashes, but it's also like clumping a lot and I feel so heavy on this eye right now. I don't know if it's the liner or if it's the mascara, but like this eye feels so heavy at this point. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply this on my lower lash line as well. There we go, our eye look is almost done. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing on this side, maybe fix the situation right here, and we will be right back to apply the lashes. This is the best I could do, and oh my god, I spent a good 10 to 15 minutes just fixing my eyeliner, and I mean, look at that. It's just so watery and liquidy, and my eyes feel so heavy right now. I don't even feel like applying the lashes, but I really want to try. So let's just try this out. I have the Huda Beauty glue. This is waterproof. Everything is waterproof somehow. But if this works out, I'm going to be extremely happy, because the one that I used to use, oh, you get a glue with this as well, which is nice. That's nice. But yeah, if this works out, I'm not going to buy a glue as of now. There we go. So we have the lashes here. And I'm going to try these out. These are going to be probably too long. I'll have to trim it. These are like the like real plasticky eyelashes. But then these were the only ones which looked like drama eyelashes. So I had to pick these up. So let's see how long these are. Too long, definitely. I'll have to trim these, and I'll be right back. So I did trim the lashes and I'm going to put the glue on and let's just try these out. It's coming out as like transparent liquid, which I've never seen a glue like this, by the way. The eyelash glue, I'll give a thumbs up because it was extremely easy to stick and it feels pretty secure too. The lashes, however, are not my favorite. They feel and look very plasticky. I mean, when you're looking up front, like up straight like this, it looks fine. But when you look down, you can see like just plasticky eyelashes, and that's not my favorite. Now, the rest of the makeup I'll finish off later on. Let's try all the lipsticks that I picked up. Okay, so for lipsticks, I have, I think, 4 products to try. Actually, 5. Hold on. So I have this thing. Actually, this is a lip liner, and this was pretty famous all around. Like, I went to the Jayanagar market as well, and I saw this everywhere, so I thought of picking one up. And this is from ADS. This is their Pro Photo Finish Color Crayon Makeup Sticks Lips with Sharpener. And then I have this rip-off of MAC. And then I have these two from Huda Beauty. So this is the shade that I tried on my eyelids, and it looks so nice. I really, really like this color on my eyelid. And then I have red pinky shade. And lastly, I have a rip-off of MAC lip gloss. So I don't know which one to try first. I think I'm going to try this one out first. Wow, I already know I'm going to hate this, but let's just try this out for the fun of it. Also, this is so heavily fragranced. I don't think I should be completely applying this. I already do not like this shade. So let me just like remove this. Let's try out the ADS lip liner. I want to see how the sharpener looks like in this one. Okay, there we go. You do have the sharpener in here, and this is how the lip liner looks like. Let's try this out. Okay, so the shade is not very friendly on my skin tone, at least, but formula wise it was quite difficult to apply. I'm not really a fan. Let's try the liquid lipstick out now. Based on how it performed on my eye, I'm hoping that it looks nice on the lips as well. This smells like chocolate. I actually like this color a lot. I think especially paired up with that lip liner, it looks really nice, and the look is pretty monochromatic. Lastly, I have another shade to try and a lip gloss. So I think I'll be trying out the shade after a while. I'm just gonna finish it off with some lip gloss just to see how it looks like. It's actually not a lip gloss. I don't know what it is. What does it say? It's a Matte Me Ultra Smooth Matte Lip Cream. So that is how it looks like. So I thought it's a lip gloss, but it's actually not. So I think I'm gonna like put it just like right at the center. It's a nice shade, I really like it. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish my entire makeup. I'm gonna add a concealer, bronzer, and all of those things, maybe a little bit of highlighter, and then we will talk about all of these products. This is the finished look. I added bronzer and a little bit of concealer, also a little bit of highlighter. I'm not sure if you can see that, but yeah, overall I think it looks pretty good. The lipstick does not feel extremely uncomfortable or drying. It just feels a little bit sticky. And I also had lunch right now, so it has faded a little bit. But overall, I think it looks pretty good. Overall, I really like this look. You cannot really tell that I have lipstick on as eyeshadow. The eyelash glue is pretty good. It's still going strong, and I'm sure I'm going to get use out of it even with other eyelashes. The eyelashes, though, are not something that I'm going to use, only because it's like so plastic and looks so fake. So definitely not my cup of tea. My eyebrows look absolutely horrendous. This is the only part which I think looks really, really bad and just out of nowhere. It's like I just like put on crayon on my eyebrows and it looks very bad. So this is not my favorite. And eyeliner was again a pain to put on. It was all over my eyelashes. It was transferring onto my lid. And overall creating wing also was pretty difficult. The lipstick color is nice. The previous one that I tried from the Huda Beauty and the other MAC one, I like both the colors. It created this very monotonous look, which I again like. So lastly, I'm gonna go ahead and try the Huda Beauty red lipstick that I have. So let me like quickly take this off. So let us try the red one out. I don't know if it's like red or pink or whatever. Let's see. Again, I'm not going to recommend or not recommend any of these products because it's totally up to you. If you are not into makeup or you just have to put on makeup for one event or something like that, maybe just go out and buy, and these can be worn for a single day or two. Definitely it's not very safe to use for the long run, but again, that's my opinion. And this video was just for fun, just to try out how these products work and everything, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in tomorrow's video. Bye bye.